Она мне чуть не на весь экран. Вот это, чтобы вот убралась, тоже можно же сделать. Итак. Так. Вы когда выписываете?
Good day, guys. We are starting our practical lesson number 3. Finding displacements using the Verishagin's method. This is your second homework on this topic. Let's look at an example of finding displacements using the Verishagin's method for the beam, which we solved in the practical lesson number 2, this beam. For a beam from table A. So, task for this beam, is necessary to find the displacements, the vertical displacement, and the angle of rotation of the section K using the Verishagin's method. Solution. Solution steps from the first to ninth are the same as for the solution using the Mohr integral. For this beam, we did this in practical lesson number 2. And we draw again the picture that we drew in practical lesson number 2. Peak 1, peak 2, and peak 3. For this peak, we found the reactions, and we wrote down the equations for bending movement. And for peak 2, we found the reaction, the new reaction, and wrote down the equation for bending movement. And also for peak 3, we found the new reaction, RA ang with line and RB ang with line. And for peak 2, RA with line ver and RB with line ver. And also we wrote down the equations for bending movements. And now we drew again the picture 1, 2, and 3 with reactions. Therefore, we begin to consider the solution from the 10th step. So, step number 10. We need to draw a divided diagram of bending movements MF. We need to divide the diagram since two forces act on the first segment. For the first segment, RA and Q. That is, we draw a diagram of bending movements from the action of each external force separately. To do this, we use the equations on the bending movements from the action of external forces, which we wrote down in practical lesson number 2. And the equation for peak 1. MF from Z1 is equal to RA multiplied by Z1 minus, beam is smiling, and minus RQ with apostrophe multiply Z1 divided by 2. RQ with apostrophe multiply this distance Z1 divided by 2. We draw the divided diagram for first term for RQ RA. MF from 0 is equal to 0. MF from 2 is equal to 30 kilonewtons. This is a straight line. that in power one, and we got the straight line. Peak number four, the straight line, 0, 30, and straight line. For the second term of equations MF from that one, minus 5 multiplied by that one in power 2. MF from 0 is equal to 0. MF from 2 is equal to minus 20 kilonewtons multiplied by meters. This is parabola. This is parabola. This is a concave curve according to rule umbrella rule. Minus 20. For second segment, MF from Z2 is equal to RB multiplied by Z2. RB multiplied by Z2, beam is smiling, with plus 5 multiplied by Z2. On this segment, there are only one force. And we don't divide the diagram on this segment. M from 0 is equal to 0. M from 2, MF from 2 is equal to 10 kilonewtons multiplied by meters. 0, 10, 10. This is a straight line. Well, the divided diagram MF is shown in picture 4. In picture 4, divided diagram. The step number 11. We draw a diagram M with light viewer. M with light viewer. To do this, we use the equations of the bending moments from the action of a vertical force equal to 1. Vertical force equal to 1, which we wrote down in a practical lesson number 2. So the equation for peak 2. M with line viewer from Z1 is equal to 1 divided by 2 multiplied by Z1. This reaction multiplied by Z1. M from 0 is equal to 0. M from 2 is equal to 1 meters. 0 and 1 meters. This is a straight line. For second segment, M with line viewer from Z2 is equal to 1 divided by 2. The RB viewer multiplied by Z2. This is mistake, Z2. Just a moment. Mm-hmm. We fix this. Mm-hmm. M from 0 is equal to 0. M from 2 is equal to 1 meters. 0, 1 meters. Now the diagram M with line viewer is shown in peak 5. This diagram. Step number 12. We draw a diagram M with line Eng. To do this, we use the equations of the bending moments from the action of a movement equal to 1. For peak 3, movement equal to 1, which we wrote down in practical lesson number 2. For peak 3, the first segment. M with line ang from that one is equal to 1 divided by 4. This reaction RA ang multiplied by that one. M from M ang from 0 is equal to 0. M ang from 2 is equal to 1 divided by 1 divided by 2. Zero and one divided by two. This value is not measured in anything. Only one divided by two. For second segment, M ang from Z2 is equal to minus one divided by four. This is a reaction RB ang minus beam is smiling multiply by Z2. M ang from 0 is equal to 0. M ang from 2 is equal to minus 1 divided by 2. 0 minus 1 divided by 2. This is also a straight line. The diagram M ang with line is shown in picture 6. In picture 6. The step number 13. We find their displacements using the Verishagin's formula 2. This formula is written as follows. Where M is the number of external forces acting on the beam. For our beam, M is equal to 3. Three external forces are A, Q, and RB. Omega I is the area on the diagram MF for the ice external force. Omega 1, omega 2, and omega 3. MCI is the movement on the diagram MC, located exactly under the center of gravity omega I. This movement MC1 with line viewer. MC1 is line N for C2. The movement MC2 is line viewer and MC2 is line N. And for omega 3, C3, center of gravity, C3. This is a AMC3 viewer and AMC3 ang. Note, to simplify the calculation in the formula two, we don't need to calculate the area omega and MC moment, MC with line before plugging them into the formula. Let's apply formula two to our ask. At first, we find the vertical displacement in the section K. Delta K ver is equal to 1 divided by E divided by IX. brackets, omega 1 multiplied by mc1 verb. Convert. Omega 1 is above zero line. Mc1 also above zero line. And this is a term with plus. Minus, because omega 2 below the zero line and mc2 above zero line. This is still is negative. With minus, minus. And for second segment, omega 3 above zero line and mc3 word above zero line. And this term with plus. 10 and power 3 divided by 2 multiplied by 10 in power 11. This is a E. And for this beam, Ix is equal to 572 multiplied by 10 and minus in power minus 8. Meters in power 4. And omega 1, this is a triangle. This is triangle. 1 divided by 2 multiplied by 30. This 30. And the length 2. This omega we calculate using the table 1. And the MC1 we calculate using the table 2. And this value is equal to 2 divided by 3 multiplied by 1. Minus. Omega 2 is the parabolic triangle. The omega for this parabolic triangle is equal to 1 divided by 3 multiply 20 multiply by MC2 with line root. MC2 using the table 2, 3 divided by 4 multiply by 1 plus omega 3 1 this is a triangle 1 divided by 2 multiply by 10 multiply by 2 and the AMC 3 with line word is equal to 2 divided by 3 multiply by 1. And we got this result. Then we find the angle of rotation of the section K. We're using the picture number 6. And picture number 4. Omega 1 is above the zero line and the MC1 angle is above the zero line. And this is a value with plus. Then omega 2 is below the zero line and MC2 above the zero line. And this term is minus. for second segment, omega 3 above zero line, MC 3 angle below zero line, and this term is minus. Omega 1, this is the same for omega where 1 divided by 2, multiply by 30, multiply by 2, and multiply by 2 divided by 3, multiply by 1 divided by 2. Using the table 2 minus omega 2, this is omega 2 for parabolic triangle, 1 divided by 3, multiply by 20, multiply by 2, the length 2, and multiply by MC 2 with line angle, this value, this moment. 3 divided by 4, multiply by 2, divided by 2, this movement. For second segment, this is a right angle triangle. Minus 2 divided by 1 divided by 2, multiply by 10, multiply by 2. This is a omega 3, and multiply by MC 3 angle, this movement. 2 divided by 3, multiply by 1 divided by 2, and we receive this value, radian. And note, we should get the same results as for the Mohr integral. The results for Verещагин's method and for Mohr integral, the same results. Please, do you have any questions for this material, for this topic? Please write in chat.